So there's a common perception that the pro plan requires mastery of JavaScript. Well, today I want to tell you that's not really the case, at least not anymore with AI. I'm going to show you how to leverage AI to generate JavaScript variables. This can also be applied to JavaScript rules, but that's for another day. Today, we're just going to cover JavaScript variables. And I want to go over some of the free chat services or free AI services that you can use to generate JavaScript variables without any knowledge of JavaScript whatsoever. And I'm going to put links to all of these services in the description below. But we're going to go over some of the most popular ones. ChatGPT, Copilot, Gemini, and my favorite, Poe, which consolidates pretty much all the popular models. And you can choose from a whole bunch of them. The secret to coming up with really good JavaScript code is in the prompt, is how you prompt the AI. And I'm going to show you the proper prompt to get the JavaScript variable to do exactly what you want it to do. In this case, let's say you want to create a variable that outputs today's date in a certain format. This is a prompt that you should use. Write a bookmarklet that returns today's date in this format. It should be one line. So if you see the output as multiple lines, you can modify the output with further prompt. Something like this. There you go. That's more like it. So once you get it in one line, make sure it starts with JavaScript colon. That's what marks it as a JavaScript variable. So copy code. And then you define the variable here. I want to call it short date. Paste it in. And there's one important step that you need to do. Look for the word alert somewhere in the code and change it to return. That's all you really have to do. And it should work. So let's save it. And let's use it in one of our rules. I'm going to fill out full name with today's date. And this is a way you reference a variable, at least this type of variable. And this should output the short date output from the JavaScript code. There you go. You don't have to stick with ChatGPT. You can experiment with other AI models. Maybe some of them will generate better code. or more to your liking. So I'm just going to copy this prompt. And try out some of the other AI models. This one's smart enough to put it on one line for us from the get-go. Cool. I'm gonna do short date two. Again, look for alert and change it to return. Works. Let's try Gemini. Oh, this one is the shortest so far. Very concise. I like it. Return. But it didn't work. Let's go back to number two. So as you can see, not all of them are the same. Let's move on. Here I'm going to select Claude because we haven't tried Claude yet, but you can try Sonnet, but Sonnet is very, let me see if they give you a free allowance. Cool, you get a free one, but multi-line. So, three didn't work. Let's go to four. Change alert to return. I think I know the reason why some of these don't work. Yeah. Just remove return. Yeah, you're gonna have to play around with it. If you are familiar with JavaScript, then it'll make the troubleshooting a lot easier. In this last one, I just noticed we don't really need the return statement. And that's why it wasn't working, because we had the return statement. So I'm going to use Copilot to come up with some other examples for you. Let's see. But if you want to generate an 8-character random alphanumeric string, let's call this ran string. Find alert. Change it to return. Ran string. All right, it should return an 8-character random alphanumeric string now. Yep. So that's pretty much it. You can use AI to do whatever you want, to return whatever string you want, number you want, any calculations you want. It's all up to your imagination and your prompting. All right, that's it for today. Until next time.